Thank you. And yes, I live in a neighborhood where e-collars are highly frowned upon, and they called animal control on me. Nothing came of it, but it was still a pain.
Yeah, nothing can come of it. So you're not breaking the law. So if it continues to happen, file a complaint for harassment. I don't give a shit what public opinion says. They're legal. I'm not breaking the law. Leave me the fuck alone. So people need to stand up for their rights more. So, of course they're frowned upon. But that doesn't mean I can't use one. It's not against the law. Don't harass me. So if animal control comes to your house, you can refuse entry. And what can I help you with? We understand you're using a shock collar. And what's your point? Are you writing a fucking report here? What are you, a newspaper reporter? What are you doing, taking a survey? So what if I'm using a shock collar? I'm allowed to. They're not against the law. And what do they say? We want to make sure you're using it properly. Say, define what that is. Do you know how to use one? What's properly? No, get off my property. You can't come in my house. You can't see my dogs. No, you can't. Just go take your business somewhere else. Don't let people fucking harass you. Even if the police show up, you have rights. You have rights. No, here's my dog. There it is right there. No, you can't pet my dog. No, you can't interact with my dog. I don't know who you are. And you're not going to watch me train my dog? No. Next.
Go live.
Now we're live. Hey guys, how are you? Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. Yeah, lighting's fine. Lighting looks good. Hey guys, we're just in our RV right now, and we just got back from dinner, so we're rushing to get the show a couple minutes late. Sorry about that. We knew we wouldn't be able to do the show till 9. So my name is Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. How's everybody doing? We're over here in Canton, Ohio right now. We did a fantastic first day of a seminar.
Yeah.
Stormy right now. I know. Fantastic, wow. Fantastic day one. There's about 45 people here. 45, 47 people here. So really, really great crowd. Happy to have everybody here. So what we're going to do right now is, holy shit, it's like coming down. Oh my gosh. I know. So what we're going to do is do a Q&A. So the way it works, I feel like I got to scream. I know.
Think about me.
I know. The way it works is you ask a question, I give an answer where it says, say something, type in your question. If you there's a little dollar sign there. Some people do something called Top Chat or Super Chat. There's a little bit of cash our way, but you don't have to do that. We'll get to as many questions as possible. Today, we're not sure if we're going to do a 60-minute or 90-minute show. We'll play it by ear. We spend a lot of time stopping unwanted behaviors. So if you're brand new to my channel, if you're brand new to my show, you're going to hear the word punishment because most people are asking how to stop something. How do I stop this? How do I stop this? How do I stop this? The only way to stop an unwanted behavior is through the proper application of a punisher. So to train stuff, we use a reward. To stop stuff, we use a punisher. And then people have to learn how to properly apply a punisher. All right, here we go.
Are we on a slope? I feel like I'm like falling out of the
seat. We are on a slope because I didn't do the auto adjust right now. Yes.
All right, nice. Scattered Storm. Hi, Jeff. My 8-month-old GSD is having resource guarding only for bones and whole prey, not toys or anything else. He bit me on Thursday, and even when I used the e-collar to make him drop it from his mouth, he is still possessive and doesn't leave it alone.
Okay.
Few people told me to try the trading method. Highly doubt that will work.
No, please don't do that. So don't do trading. We don't trade up. You're not JCPenney's. We don't trade dogs for stuff. If anything, that teaches the dog to guard things even more. So the dog will think, oh, yeah, I'll release that if you pay me enough money, which is like, what, food? Something of higher value. So what exactly is higher value? And what happens when you're outside and the dog picks up a stick and thinks the stick is worth $1 million? You got something higher value than a stick? I do. It's called a shock collar correction. You make it suck. So what you're doing is it's not just about the dog dropping it. It's a dog about disengaging. You want the dog to physically and mentally disengage from the thing. So you say out. We use the word out. use the collar at a level that makes the dog spit the item out.
Sorry.
Be really careful with your feet, hon.
Sorry.
Okay, be really careful. And then you say out again to get the dog to back up if you have to. Next.
Vegan power couple. My dog places or downs himself and thinks that I did it, meaning he goes to his place or down without me telling him. Is this normal? Should I correct because he's doing it without
me? No, what are you fucking nuts? Vegan power couple, why would you freaking correct your dog for going and lying down somewhere? No. I mean, if you told your dog to sit and it did it, yeah. But if it's just wheeling about and it goes and lies down, isn't that what we want? I'm glad that your dog is finally going and relaxing instead of driving you crazy. Next.
Tiffany, hello, Canton, Ohio, from Medina. It was a beautiful day here.
Hey, Tiffany, we miss you here, but I'll see you at T3. Next.
Kaylee J, good evening, Jeff and Joelle. Hope the seminar is going well as always.
Seminar's fantastic. You go to jeffgelmanseminars.com, jeffgelmanseminars.com, to see the schedule. After this, we head up to Canada, going across the border to Canada.
Yeah.
If they let me in. Next.
Holding on dog training. Happy Saturday, Jeff and Joelle. The seminar picks are great. What a turnout. Travel safe.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Ashley. I'm loving that you gave up smoking, too. Next.
Vegan power couple. When a runner or other dog nears us on a walk, my dog starts getting really excited and tries to run with them or play. What is protocol to correct? I have a prong and e-collar. Thank you.
The first sign of arousal, you would say no and correct that. So, also, is your dog walking in a proper heel next to you? Is your dog walking next to you properly, like in a proper heel, or are you giving your dog too much leash freedom? So, for starters, have your dog walk, be making sure it's walking next to you in a proper heel, and then you'd be able to correct it. But how can a dog be running, trying to run with somebody if it's walking next to you? So just check in with that first. And then if any of the dog pays attention to a runner, you correct that. You correct that. Next.
Melanie, thank you for all your content. Working hard past Fortnite with my Roddy Ragnar. And yippee, he can now be in the same room as my granddaughters, age 2 and 8 weeks. First time ever the whole weekend.
Awesome. Proud of you. And work on duration a lot. Next.
Melissa says, hi, Jeff and Joelle.
Hey, Melissa. Hey, how Melissa. Are you?
Eterna dog training. Audio sounds good. Can't even pick up the rain.
Good. Thank you.
Ray Ruffino. Me again. List of fear. Bicycle, mailman, UPS trucks, motorcycle.
So your dog's afraid of all those things? Okay. So what you're going to do is this. Is you have your dog healing next to you. Because all these things are sort of like outside during a walk. So if your dog's in a proper heel. So prong collar on your dog, watch a video how to introduce a prong collar, how to fit it, introduce it, start the walk, walk the dog on a prong in low environmental areas, perfect the walk as perfect as you can get, then go to higher environmental areas with distractions, and then you're going to probably be doing some more popping to correct the dog coming out of command. And all you can do is move forward. A lot of people are going to say, oh, use food. I'm not against using food. We train with food all the time, but a fearful dog won't take food. Next.
Amy signed up for Fargo seminar. Hope we can make good progress with our dog. Was at a park today, sat good distance away from everyone. He seemed to have a few mental breakdowns. Couldn't stay calm.
Yeah, we'll work on that. We'll make some progress. Don't worry. We always make progress with dogs at our seminars. Next.
Double DD. First, thank you guys so much for what you do. I have so much appreciation and respect. Just wondering if there's a particular brand or material of bite toy you would suggest.
You can go to Ray Allen. Go to rayallen.com. Go to rayallen.com. They've got a lot of good bite toys there. So tell them we sent you. Next.
Is that lightning?
That was lightning.
Step store. Hi, Jeff.
I hope the RV is grounded. Could you imagine if we got a lightning strike on the RV?
Just add this to the list of shit I'm afraid of.
Jeez, could you imagine that?
Don't make me paranoid. There's rubber. Wheels.
Uh-huh.
Aren't you safe in vehicles?
Uh-huh.
Step store. Hey, Jeff. When is the appropriate age to use training tools such as prong collars, choke chains, etc.?
Well, we don't use choke chains at all. So in my opinion, never on a choke chain. There's a huge difference between a choke chain and a prong collar. A humongous difference between a choke chain and a prong collar. Choke chains choke dogs. Prong collars cannot. They look barbaric, but they don't impale the dog. Has never happened. I'm sure there's a dog out there that it has. But 7,000 dogs later, I'm still waiting for me to do it. And it hasn't happened. So all depends on what you're trying to train to do. Usually 14 weeks is a good time to do it, but also it depends on your skill set. So what's your, you know, what's your skill set? So I don't know. You have to make sure that you've got a gentle touch when you're doing it that young. Next.
Andrew, hi from Australia. Walking dog with e-collar and prong. Early on our walks, when approaching dogs, he crouches and pops up and down. Doesn't lunge, but cries.
That's all excitement.
Ignore it or correct.
No, you correct. That's all arousal and excitement. Next.
Julian, when playing fetch, if another dog tries to join in or chase my dog, will make an aggressive move and run him off. What would you do?
I would leave that alone. I mean, this is the thing. If I'm playing fetch with my dogs and other dogs come in, I'm gone. I leave. I'm not interested. Fetch to me is not a group sport with other people. Fetch, I mean, with my pack, it is. So, like, I'm traveling with three dogs right now. They play fetch. You know, there's the three of them. But I wouldn't allow another dog to come into the mix. Why? I have no idea about that dog's behavior. I've got no idea. And here it is in drive, running with my dog, running at my dog. If they all of a sudden are starting to chase a ball, I have no idea what that dog's going to do. Next.
JP Schwartz, Judy, great to join you.
Hey, Judy, how are you?
Sarah, when should you use wrong instead of no? And how do you give wrong meaning? I know what yes and break are for, but do you break the dog before food reward or keep them in position? Thank you.
Both. You can break the dog between. It all depends on your training philosophy. So it all depends on your training philosophy, your training program. So what you can do is on break, you can just break and then you can reward. But as far as wrong, we use wrong when we're training obedience. And we don't say no yet. So we don't correct a dog on obedience until it knows the command really well. So we've done it hundreds of times. But if, say, we say place, the dog goes to place, but then walks off of place, we would just say wrong, and then place, and then lead the dog back. So wrong sort of just says, that was wrong. Let's do it again. But it's not no. Next.
C-Dubs Fitness. Been training people's dogs now about a year and have learned so much from you.
Oh, awesome. Congratulations.
Thank you so much. Just successfully rehabbed my first aggression case. Thanks for all the free education.
Wow. Yeah, that's a challenge. Remember, those guys can be challenging. Be super careful. Next.
Sandra, bonked twice. Worked great. Now she's looking for the bonker when she screws up. Guess I need to get real with the e-collar. She's playing me, yeah?
Yeah. Next.
Kim, I just watched the training with Brick, the pit bull, again. I tear up every time.
Yeah, Brick. I know. Yeah, a lot of people have been mentioning Brick's video lately.
I feel like every show. Like, it's like your number one video.
I think it's our number three video, actually. Mm. Yeah. So, Brick's a popular video. Next.
Scattered Storm. That's what I thought. I'm pretty sure he'd bite me again. Might work for a much younger puppy, but my dog is hard as nails. Had to knock it up to 80 to get him to get a yelp. It was like a 15.
But I wouldn't do the exchange with even a young dog. There's no fucking way I'm going to teach you to hold on to stuff. No, it doesn't work that way. It's like, imagine your kid steals something from Walgreens and you're like, put it back. And they're like, well, what are you going to give me? I'm like, I'll give you a fucking ass whooping if you don't. Next.
Leanne, my two dogs tend to react by attacking each other when we see other dogs in a walk.
Yeah.
They're fine when walking separately, but together start a fight. How can I get them to be okay walking together?
Muzzle them up together. And let them know that fighting sucks. Remote collars on that. Set it up though. Don't do it like out in public. Set it up like with, get a friend with another dog and set it up. That's how I would start. That's going to be a little bit complicated to do because they're trying to fight each other. We would do that in a very controlled environment. But I would also say, what's the rest of your day look like? What's the rest of your day look like? What I mean by that is, are you holding these dogs accountable in all areas of their life? Like how they go in and out of a crate, how they go to place and stay on place, how they don't bark. Maybe there's no free roaming in the house. So what I would do is I would step up your training to start resembling, it doesn't have to be the way we train, but the lifestyle we lead of no free roaming, nothing in life is free. I'm gonna hold you accountable. I'm gonna correct you, apply a punisher for small infractions. And then on the walk, things just organically get better. Next.
Vegan power couple. If my dog doesn't want to eat his food because he's picky, what would Jeff do? Leave food down for 30 minutes and then take it away or what?
I'd leave it down.
I give him variety, but after a while, he stops liking whatever I give him.
Yeah, stop that. Stop. Your dog is not allowed to have a menu where they can pick and choose. Now, do I switch it up? I feed raw, and my dogs go through different cycles of meals. Not because they're picky. My dogs will eat anything you put in front of them. I feed once a day. It doesn't make a difference how many times a day. You can you feed. But the bottom line is you might be overfeeding your dog. What you do is you put your food down. I put the food down for 10 minutes. My dogs eat food in minutes, but your average dog should be able to eat its daily food in 10 minutes. If it doesn't eat it, take it away. Next.
Kaylee J, kind of random, but what would your best piece of personal development advice be?
Best piece of personal advice would be, well, I guess we have to figure out what your goals are in life. But a couple of things you can, that I can tell you. Number one, stop fucking complaining because nobody gives a shit about you. Number one, stop making excuses because all they are is excuses. All right. Nobody's going to do anything for you. You're sort of on your own. Hard work trumps just about everything. That and being nice. So hard work and being nice trumps everything. Stop watching the news. Stop reading the daily newspaper. Stop hanging out with toxic friends. That's probably actually the big one. Mm-hmm. Is that. Take 100% responsibility for everything. Like my buddy Larry Winget says, if your life sucks, that's because you suck. There's truth to that. But the big thing is taking 100% responsibility for everything. Own up to all of it. Stop blaming shit on your circumstances. Nobody wants to hear you complain and cry about your circumstances. Do something about them. Next.
Jessica, so to get a longer place or down, should I hold the reward until I'm ready to release
him? No.
Will that help keep him there?
No, it will not. Nope. Today I demonstrated how to do a longer placer down. Once a dog knows the command. So you're trying to tell me that if a bunch of dogs run by or a bunch of kids run by or a bunch of deer run by or somebody knocks on the door, ring the doorbell, by you withholding the food reward is going to help that dog stay? Historically, it won't. The way you get dogs to stay on command is through the proper application of a punisher for breaking a known command. If the dog knows down, for instance, you've done down hundreds of times. You say down, the dog downs. That means it knows it. The next step is dog breaks down. No. Pop with the leash. We did that today with that little white dog. We used a remote collar correction on place.
Mm-hmm.
So the dog knows place. But it often breaks place. It comes off. It's a little white 20-pound fluffy dog. What do they call them dogs? White fluffy dogs. I don't know what they are. So anyway, it's got a cute little haircut. It's one of the ones you got to groom a lot. You know, they get boogers in their eyes.
I was there.
I know. You got photos of the dog. So anyway, so the dog breaks place all the time. Follows the owner around. So what do I do? Leash on the dog. It had a remote collar on. I put the dog on place. Let it sit there for about 10, 15 seconds. I'm holding the leash. I walk forward. The dog starts coming off. I say no, correct with the remote collar. The dog goes, oh shit, that sucked. Gets back on, and I led the dog back on a place. That dog wouldn't move off a place after that. I couldn't get the dog to move off a place. I tried to get the dog to move off a place, but I wouldn't. So then I said break, and the dog came off. So the goal is the dog stays in command until you say break. And it works. So a punisher with a known command gets you duration around environmental distractions and when you are at a distance from your dog. That's how you get dogs to hold commands, not by extending the reward or giving them more rewards. So then a lot of people turn that around and say, oh, so my dog's only holding the command because it's afraid of getting punished. Yep. Sounds good to me. But your dog's not sitting there in fear going, oh shit, I hope I don't get punished. Dogs don't think like that. What's the dog doing? I guess I'm not supposed to move yet because I didn't hear the brake command. Because I know when I leave, it sucks. I highly doubt they're thinking that either. They just know not to brake command anymore. Next.
Ryan, would you let a puppy 5.5-month-old be goofy in place? He stays there for hours and sometimes rolls around, bites tail, feet, and wallows on his back. Should I correct or let it be?
I'd correct. Next.
Small Engine Luca. Joelle, rubber tires don't help you when your vehicle is struck by lightning. Is that like an old wives' tale?
Probably. Hmm. But standing on the fucking roof ain't going to be any better.
So if we get struck by lightning.
If this RV gets if this RV gets struck by lightning, we're fucked. Guess what?
You're booking me a flight back to Providence. We ain't going on the road if this shit gets struck by lightning.
I'll go buy another one.
Overnight.
Yeah. There's a dealership right down the street. Let's walk in there and buy another one. Next.
Melanie, duration is the hardest thing with him. Any tips, please?
I just told you the tip on duration on the last question. That's exactly how you do it. Next.
Blake, I gave my neighbor my old prong collar. Now his walks are easier. I showed him the dance.
Awesome. Good job, Blake. Next.
Ray Ruffino, been using Bonker. E-collar working great, but he recently bit a woman on the hand without any warning.
Well, there's always a warning. You might not admit, you might have, first of all, sorry that happened. You might have missed the warning. There's always something. There's always a tell. Sometimes in the moment, you can't see it, but if we watch the video back, we'd probably be able to see it. So what was the, not that it's the woman's fault, how was the dog able to bite someone? Did the dog just walk by and lunge at the woman's hand? Did the woman come in and put the hand towards the dog? That's one of the tells. A lot of dogs don't like that, going towards their head. They're like, it freaks all you guys out, right? So there's always a tell. After the fact, there's not much you can do. So what I would do is, I need a lot more information on how to fix it though. But pretty much, there's probably, the dog was showing a little bit of nervousness, uneasiness, concern, something that would have been a tell. Next.
Dre, oh, RV time. Hey, guys.
Hey, guys. What's up, Dre? How are you? If you haven't liked our channel, like, follow Solid Canine Training. Follow us. Turn on your notifications so you get alerted about these not only the lives, but every time we put up a new video. We put up a couple of videos a day at least. Next.
Scattered storm. We're in the country and there's no out of control crazy dogs. We go to PetSmart now and stock their training classes.
Yeah.
But it was a shock to see someone walking in, beating, slapping, and choking their dog. New low.
What? In public? My gosh. That's an interesting concept. Next.
Scattered storm. Your second response cracked me up. I'd whip my kid's butt too. LOL.
Yeah. Next.
Melissa, who wants to train with Jeff in Vegas? She posted the link below. Oh,
nice. Vegas is going to be great. Next.
Anthony, hey guys. Can't stay, but wanted to say hello and safe travels. I feel like I really have to scream right now. Don't forget to sport that knucklehead canine shirt. Haha, there's only one knucklehead. Take it easy.
Thanks, Anthony. How are you?
Scattered storm. What do you suggest if prongs, remotes, and crates are legally prohibited? Yes, we ought to fight to make it legal, but if it's illegal, what to do in the meantime?
Crates? Like, so you're in Sweden. So if you... That's hail. Fuck.
That's bad.
It's going to fuck up the RV big time.
Are you sure there's such big raindrops?
That's hail. Oh, well.
Weather the storm.
Anybody want to buy an RV with a dented roof? Give me a call. So you can train a dog without those tools. You're just going to use a lot of compulsion to train them. That's all. Next.
Abby, first live stream I'm watching, and it's 2 a.m. in the middle of exams. Thanks for all your amazing free content. Keep up the work.
Awesome. Fuck your exams. They won't get you anywhere. Next.
Elijah, how do you go about correcting bad behavior in public, like puppy nipping? Should I feel weird about using the e-collar to where he yelps loudly in public and everyone looks over at us?
No, but I would eliminate all that stuff. When you say puppy, how old's the puppy? But I would eliminate that stuff at home first. Puppy nipping can be, you can get rid of puppy nipping in one session. So I'd get rid of that. So maybe you're not using the right choice of words, but like, is the dog biting the leash? Is the dog biting you? Like, I need to know a little bit more about what's going on, but dog's biting us, if it's a puppy. When you say puppy, I'm thinking 14 weeks and under. That's easy to fix. Next.
Tracy, hi, J&J. Just got e-collar, but need to wait to use until Monday when I have time to work with him. How long to layer with other training before I can use for correction? Leash reactive with other dogs.
You can use it for leash reactivity right away. That's different. That's stopping an unwanted behavior. Next.
Marissa, I have two huskies that have perfect recall on e-collar. But as soon as I take it off, they know and they will stay close. As long as they don't have anything that sets them off. An example, people or toys.
Okay. What's the question? Keep the remote collars on your dog. I don't know how long you've been working on remote collar. I don't know if you've ever got to know punishment level. But if your dogs are doing great with the tools, why would you take off the tools? Because some dog trainer said to you, oh, you're lazy. So from a dog trainer that said to you, oh, your dogs really aren't trained. For some dog trainer that said, oh, you've got to manage your dog. From some dog trainer said, oh, well, if you did a better job, you wouldn't need the shock collar. Fuck them all. Fuck them all. The hell with them all. Tell them to go fuck themselves if that's what happened. If you're doing it, though, because you feel like you didn't do a good enough job, well, you're wrong. You did. There's a skill set to train a dog to recall on a remote collar. People think, oh, you just push a button, they come running back. That usually does not happen. So there's a skill set to that. So what I would say is, if things are working out, why make it harder for you? Make life easier for you. Next.
Top chat.
Oh, top chat. $5. Sandra. Hey, Sandra. How are you? Jeff, because I love you all madly and I'm thankful for all you do. Hey, Sandra, tell your mom and tell your dad. Oh, no, wrong buck. Forget it. Tell your mom and dad I said hi if they're alive. I was thinking of another. Weren't you thinking
Nicole.
Of? I'm thinking of Nicole Buck. So. Nicole Buck, she hosted our Buck's Dog Training. She hosted our seminar in
New Jersey.
And we went out to dinner with her mom and her dad, who are really, really nice. They're a lot of fun. And I thought that's who you were. But I know who you are, Sandra. You're on the show every week.
I thought that's who you were. Josue says thank you.
You're welcome, Josue.
Elijah, thanks for everything you do.
Why are you laughing at me?
Can you use a bonker for whining? If so, when is the right timing?
When the dog's whining. Not when the dog stops the whining, when the dog whines. Say no, deploy the bonker. Next.
Ooh, Marnie Cool Dog says good advice.
Okay, cool.
John Rodriguez.
I don't know what that's about.
Stop. I cannot deal with you tonight.
Which part's the good advice?
John.
Saying hello to people's parents?
Stop it.
That's good advice.
Hush.
Hold on. You're yelling at me? You just told me not to ever hush you. You just said to me, don't you ever hush me.
He was freaking hushing me.
I was not hushing you.
You literally said, shh.
Why?
I don't remember, but you did.
I didn't say shh to you.
You did.
I wouldn't say shh to me. I would never shush you.
John Rodriguez.
I know better than that.
Clearly not. My dog has a history of snapping at small kids. What would Jeff do?
What please the fuck? Help.
No, I don't like this lighting. Put that back, please. Put it back.
You want it brighter?
Brighter. Bright as fuck. That's better. I already look tired enough. John, my dog has a history of snapping at small kids. What would Jeff do?
Well, that's a little bit complicated. So I need to know, number one, what's going on? Bottom line is, for now, keep the dog away from children. That's not the answer. That's definitely not the answer. But I need to know a lot more information so I can help you rehab the dog. I don't need to know the backstory, but I need to know more about, like, where this is happening, when it's happening. Is the dog on leash? Is the dog off leash? Are these kids rushing your dog, trying to pet them? Is your dog going after kids? There's a lot of variables that I need to know. Stuff like this, people do Skypes for. So I don't do this show to build my Skype business, but I offer a Skype service. So you can go to solidcaninetraining.com in the shopping cart. You can get a Skype if you wanted to, but you don't have to. But I would need way more information, you know, on this to just be like, oh, well, I'll just correct it. Like, I need to know, like, what the setup is when the snapping is happening. Next.
Ree Rufino, just to clarify, he bit women before using the e-collar on him. I don't know what that's in reference to.
Okay, next.
Robin, hi guys. Just wanted to tell you guys about the mix I saw at the pet shop. Ready? German Shepherd and Pomeranian mix. I don't know why those two dogs would be bred.
I'd like to see the fucking video. That's got to be a fucking trip. Who was on top on that one? See the fucking Pomeranian spinning around like a fucking top. Next.
Dre, that new lighting setup is bright as fuck.
Thank you. That's why I tried to, make it not so bright. It's one of those circle lights that we take on the road now. It's the first time we've used it on the road. It's got cool, which she doesn't like.
No.
Soft, which I think is really, really nice.
Warm and bright.
And this is bright. And she likes bright, obviously, is brightest. So
bright and warm, like the sun.
It's not warm, though. That's bright. Warm is a different mode. So here, look. This is warm. See, I like that.
I like that, too.
Then why the fuck haven't I been able to do that?
You didn't try.
I've tried it back at home.
We've always done warm, haven't we?
No, we do bright. You
I
want
still
bright.
Think I like bright better. It's better for your, like, it just makes you look better.
I'll do warm.
I need all the help I can get.
You're beautiful. Bullshit. I'll do warm and bright.
All right, fine.
Next.
Sarah, just learned that some dogs like doodles need a ton of grooming. How do you deal with board and trains that require a lot of grooming?
We groom them.
We groom them.
You're the one that wants to be a fucking dog trainer. You're the one that wants to make the money. So if you want to have a doodle fee, a doodle grooming fee, go right ahead. I'd subcontract it out. I'd bring somebody else in. So what you can do is you can say, listen, I've got to have a groomer come in once a week to do like some grooming. The client can pay for that or do it yourself as an added service. Next.
Sasha, today I'm walking my lab, who's one. A dog ran at us off the leash. Fuck. I made my dog heel. It was not listening to its owner and had no leash or collar on. I found it annoying.
Annoying? It's dangerous.
Jeez, she's a very mellow
dangerous.
Lady.
Yeah. If that dog comes rushing at you, get ready to kick. Always get ready to kick. Next.
Jacqueline, hi. How long should I do crate training for? How many times for a day? And how long should I leave him in there? My first time starting, he's been in for almost 1 hour, but he's barking and whining.
Okay, the barking and whining, you shut up. How long should the dog be in there? Well, you're sleeping tonight, so tonight the dog should be in there overnight. This concept that people have for their crate training of, oh, do like 5 minutes of it at a time is bullshit. How are we supposed to go to work? How are we supposed to go to sleep? You go in the crate and you lie down and you be quiet, or be quiet and you lie down. So if the dog's barking in the crate, walk up to it and hit the top of it. Hit the side of it. Bonk it. Use a remote collar to shut the dog up. So we have dogs. We had dogs at the seminar today. It was a little bit of hectic at the beginning. Mm-hmm. We had about 30 minutes of nonsense going on. It's like 20 dogs there. A little bit of nonsense to a lot of bit of nonsense.
Yeah.
And we shut those dogs up in 30 minutes. Normally, the record's like 10.
Yeah.
Where do we shut them up in 10 minutes? Was that New Jersey?
Jersey.
Indiana?
I think it was Indiana.
Yeah, we had a seminar 10 minutes by 9:10. Quiet. Tomorrow morning, they'll all be quiet. Yeah. But it was a shit show. So, but you got to stop them. So if I can stop 20 dogs, it's not because I'm a dog trainer. You can stop yours. So what do? You make it suck to whine and bark. And a lot of the people are going to say, no, don't do that. The crate's supposed to be a place that they enjoy. The fuck? The dog doesn't enjoy the crate. I'm not making it any worse. This concept that, oh, what are you going to do? Put an L.L. Bean embroidered bed in there, play some music, light some candles, give the dog some chew toys, and then it'll stop barking. That's the biggest bunch of bullshit in the world. You have a dog that freaking rips up the dog bed, pisses all over the place, and, like, you know, takes the water and spills it. So just tell the dog to shut up. Next.
Ray Rufino, yes, all what you've mentioned, fear and aggressive. He's scared of everything. She came to him too fast, and he bit.
Oh, got it. Yeah. So thank you, Ray. Now I understand. So what I need you to do is this. Dog should have a muzzle on in public right now. And it's your job to keep people away from your dog. Don't let anybody pet your dog. I'm a huge advocate of people not petting our dogs. So my dogs are social. Anybody can theoretically pet them. I don't let anybody pet my dogs because I'm just trying to change people's attitudes so they understand that it's not acceptable to walk up to a dog that doesn't belong to you and pet it. And frankly, don't even ask. Leave other people's dogs alone. Like, I didn't get a dog for your enjoyment. Look, enjoy it with your eyes. Hell, take a picture, make it your freaking screensaver if you want to. I'll even pose them if you want. But leave my dogs alone, please. I didn't get them from you. All right? They're not for you. They're my dogs. I got them for myself. My family can enjoy them, and that's it. So stay away from me. I just feel that way. And we'd have a lot less problems. We'd have a lot less dog bites. We'd have a lot less nonsense. We'd have a lot less of dog reactivity. Because leash reactive dogs are also dogs that want to go play with another dog. They pull towards humans. They pull towards dogs just to play with them. So let's put a kibosh on all this meet and greet stuff next.
My dogs are my screensaver.
I know they are. But those are your dogs.
Emily, what adaptive bonker techniques do you have for someone with limited upper extremity strength?
Probably don't want to use a bonker. Probably want to use a remote collar instead, because you don't need to be strong then.
Next,
sorry, I was yawning.
Michelle, no need to yell, Joelle. We can hear you just fine. Sorry. I'll talk quieter. Terry, my dog walks nicely with me. I'm the one who trains, but he has trouble behaving when my husband walks with us, gets excited, breaks heel.
So what I want you to do is this. Is you're going to have to teach your husband what you did. Teach your husband how you did it. But he's probably not going to be good with your husband as he is with you right now, because you're the primary person. But if you teach that dog on the remote collar, teach that dog all the mechanics, teach that dog what no means with the remote collar, so it gets the dog back into place and heal, that's going to help your husband. Or just work with your husband. I don't know what kind of teacher you are. Sometimes spouses should be teaching each other. Sometimes they shouldn't. So sometimes spouses shouldn't be even living in the same fucking house as each other.
Hey, we're on the last leg here. It's almost done.
You're almost divorced.
Almost.
What do you got, another week?
Probably.
Really?
Yeah. Everything gets signed on Monday.
You have a party?
Maybe. A divorce party.
You should.
I don't really know what you do with those, but figure it out. I'll have a glass of water, please.
Can I get an extra crouton on my salad?
Melanie, that must be some storm. Can see flashes behind Joelle. Stay safe, guys.
Yep. Next. This could be a skylight here.
It's already over.
Yep.
Scattered storm. I'm in Indiana, actually. Just wanted your opinion on that. Sweden is so lost. There's a social security CPS worker assigned to every child in there. Nanny state.
Yep. It's really, really bad in Sweden right now. And everyone's like celebrating that, yeah, dogs don't have to be in crates anymore. It's like, yeah, ask all the dog owners how that's going. Ask my fellow dog trainers in Sweden what kind of fucking shit show that is. Ask how many dogs are being turned in and killed over there. That they don't tell you about. Anytime there's too much government, it's not a good thing. It's not a good thing at all. Next.
Andy, hi, I was told dog aggressive dogs can be rehabilitated. Is this true?
Can or cannot?
Can't.
You were told that by somebody who doesn't know how to do it. Obviously, they can't do it. Yes, they can be rehabilitated. So can an alcoholic. So can a drug addict. Yes, they can. We do it. So we do it. Do some of them not work out? Yeah. Some of them don't work out. It's not magic. We're not magicians. They're dogs. Like, some dogs have limits, but we're really good. You know, everything from business to my own personal dogs, I've really rehabilitated aggression. But I've also owned dogs that I couldn't get to a level that was safe enough. So I put them down. They weren't safe anymore. So I'm a big advocate of giving a dog a good chance. And we've got a skill set. Most dog trainers don't work with aggression. So you have to find one that actually works with aggression. Find one that's successful. But can every dog be rehabilitated? Probably not. In fact, no. And that also depends on the person's skill set. But even the best skill sets, some of them cannot be. Next.
Tracy, once I get working level on e-collar, how high do I go for sucky experience for him? Loving your free content. Thank you for helping us have great dogs.
You're welcome. Play it by ear. Play it by ear. What you're going to do is, the dogs don't let you know what the right level is. Theoretically, the dogs control the levels. You look at the dog. You pay attention to the dog. The dog's doing a behavior that you don't like. Figure out what level it is to make the dog stop. And then look at the remote. Oh, okay. 57 it was. Next.
Marissa, thank you. And yes, I live in a neighborhood where e-collars are highly frowned upon, and they called animal control on me. Nothing came of it, but it was still a pain.
Yeah, nothing can come of it. So you're not breaking the law. So if it continues to happen, file a complaint for harassment. I don't give a shit what public opinion says. They're legal. I'm not breaking the law. Leave me the fuck alone. So people need to stand up for their rights more. So, of course they're frowned upon. But that doesn't mean I can't use one. It's not against the law. Don't harass me. So if animal control comes to your house, you can refuse entry. And what can I help you with? We understand you're using a shock collar. And what's your point? Are you writing a fucking report here? What are you, a newspaper reporter? What are you doing, taking a survey? So what if I'm using a shock collar? I'm allowed to. They're not against the law. And what do they say? We want to make sure you're using it properly. Say, define what that is. Do you know how to use one? What's properly? No, get off my property. You can't come in my house. You can't see my dogs. No, you can't. Just go take your business somewhere else. Don't let people fucking harass you. Even if the police show up, you have rights. You have rights. No. Here's my dog. There it is right there. No, you can't pet my dog. No, you can't interact with my dog. I don't know who you are. And you're not going to watch me train my dog? No. Next.
Melanie, I'm in stitches. LOL, LOL.
See that?
That had to have been about something earlier.
Probably something you did.
Probably. Next. John, thank you, Jeff.
You're welcome.
Sheesh, I can't even see. Lilia, I've been watching your videos and it was rough for a session, but our walk yesterday was the best. We haven't been able to do that before.
Good.
Can't wait to take him more places and train more. Thank you.
Congratulations. Yeah, the great thing about training is your world really, really expands. I work so hard and I work so passionately because people's lives are really, really small. Like, people's worlds get really, really small. When you got a badly behaved dog, then you can't do shit with your dog. Next.
Emma, hi, love you. In a scenario where you're walking your dog and another dog off leash comes charging towards you, what would Jeff do?
Kick
it. I'm a small woman. I'm wondering what the best thing to do is. Thanks.
Where you can kick the dog and everyone, if everybody that struggles with that
concept. Every show someone asks us so, like.
I know. If people struggle with that concept, you've never seen a dog killed in front of you before. You've never seen a dog attacked before. Dog attacks are horrific. Dog attacks are horrific. I wish that upon nobody. So you neutralize the threat. Bear spray, pepper spray, kick the dog, hiking stick, anything you can to neutralize the threat. Next.
It's crazy how often this stuff happens.
It's beyond. In 2019, it's becoming more and more common. That's why we have to train for 2019.
Mm-hmm. Karen, GSD lover. Good evening, Jeff and Joelle. Thanks for your spot on advice.
Oh, you're welcome.
Double DD. Joelle, if he shushed you, you just say no and bonk.
Listen to me. Listen to me. Listen to me. I'm not a fucking stupid man. I am not a stupid man. I do not shush females.
You did.
I did not. I don't fucking shush females. No fucking way.
The 1% of his life I didn't get on camera.
Next.
Shushed me. Scattered storm. Also, yes, the people were beating the dog. One look at them, and it's just one of those people who clearly shouldn't own a dog and need to clean up their life before they have a heart full enough to pour into a dog.
What's this? A Petco?
Mm-hmm.
Next.
MW, my dog was planted and stubborn. I watched your free Skype about it with Anne. I put the collar on her and was turning it up when a firework went off and scared the crap out of her. Problem solved.
There you go. Next.
Britain. I saw your Instagram today, every day, really. How did you break the dog of 2 years jumping in 10 minutes?
Oh, it didn't take 10 minutes. It took 10 seconds. Did it say 10 minutes?
I think it said 2 minutes. That was a repost from Julia. She, like, put it on her stories, and I reposted it.
Oh, really?
She said in under 2 minutes.
Yeah. I've got a video on how to stop jumping. Stopping jumping is easier than training a sit. It's easy to stop a dog from jumping. You make jumping suck. But it's a very choreographed protocol that I do. Extremely highly choreographed. I do it at every single seminar at least one time. I show it in real time. I do it in front of everybody. I don't hold back. and dogs make better choices. Dogs make better choices. We stopped the dog from an OCD behavior. 2.5 years.
That spinning. Yeah.
2.5 years. A German Shepherd spinning in its crate, biting its tail. I got that dog to lie down in about 5 seconds. It took 1 second to stop it from spinning. It took me about 4 seconds to get the dog to lie down. And I did that all with no voice, no commands, just a remote collar. Yep. I'm not bragging. I'm just saying, though, what I'm saying is this stuff's easier than you think. And you learn it all at the seminars. But, I mean, if you have it on video, do you have that on video?
I do, but the freaking audio, it's so
loud. I'll overdub it. I'll just overdub. I'll explain what I do. But you're showing the dog?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, I'll just overdub it. I'll do a voiceover. We got like 100 videos to fucking do.
No shit. Fuck. We have so many.
You know what we should do? We got time to get to Canada.
I haven't even put up the new dog yet because I'm still waiting to edit the intake.
This is what we should do. Seriously. Maybe we should stay here an extra day.
Maybe.
Let me ask Eric if we have permission to stay here. We have good Wi-Fi. The gym's down the street.
Mm-hmm.
We got a place to park. Maybe we should stay here and we can run the dogs and we can literally, we've got Wi-Fi, which is important. I can make my phone calls. We can get all of our video editing done. Mm-hmm. Let's do that.
Okay.
Okay. Next.
Jessica.
But you wanted to see Niagara Falls.
I did. We go on the way back, right?
Keep going.
8 weeks practicing heel in backyard and up and down driveway with e-collar. Took dog to empty college parking lot
awesome.
Today. Successfully walked one's highly reactive pity by three dogs and squirrel with only whining. So grateful.
Wow. Holy shit. Good job.
John, would you use Bonker for a small dog who responds well to the e-collar?
Yes. It's 7 hours to Collingwood.
That's not bad.
400 miles. It's a day's drive.
Yeah.
We leave Wednesday. We hang out in Niagara Falls for a day. Thursday, we head up there. We leave here Wednesday morning. Let's ask Eric permission if we can stay on his property. Next. Eric, if you're watching this, can we stay on your property? Next.
He said he was going to watch. Next. Red Riding Hood and the Wolf. Hey, Jeff and Joelle. Got 3-month-old Pomsky 2 days ago. How do I make him stop whining in his cage when I leave the room? Also, do a potty training tips.
I
go out with him for an hour and he does nothing. Then I bring him inside and he pees on the floor.
Okay, this is what you're going to do with the potty training stuff. When you come back in, he goes back in his kennel. The dog doesn't come out of the kennel, but you got to take him out to go to the bathroom. The dog does not get any freedom until he pisses and shits outside, or at least pees. Okay? Also, stand still, have the dog go out and go to the bathroom. Don't move around. Hold your ground, give the dog the leash, okay? What you're going to do as far as whining in the crate, no, and then bonk. If you guys want to know what a bonker is, just go to my YouTube channel, which you're on right now, search bonkers. Search Bonker. Next.
Terry, thanks so much. My first time. Love your videos.
Oh, thank you.
Sandra, play drive versus prey drive. What would Jeff do?
What's the problem with either?
I think they just want to know the difference.
Oh, look it up on Google. Everyone's got their own opinion on that. But I'm not, like, neither of those things are bad. Prey drive's not bad. Play drive's not bad. Mm-mm. Dog's going into defense, defensive drive. That's not bad. All depends on what you want it to do. So I need to know what you want it to do. But I don't get rid of any of those things. I leave all the drives intact. We can manipulate them a little bit and we can use them to our advantage a little bit. But I'm not trying to get rid of drive and dog. Arousal I want to get rid of, but that's different than drive. Next.
Elsie, my 1-year-old Doberman insists on playing rough with other dogs. I've tried remote collar, he still doesn't get it. What can I do? Keep trying with the collar?
What I would do is I wouldn't let my dog play with other dogs because I don't want a dog fight. I don't want a dog fight, but I don't know what your skill set is with a remote collar. I don't know the protocol you're using. I don't know the timing. I don't know what levels you're using. I'm not sure the brand of the collar that you're using. So it might be something I'm not familiar with. Like someone's got a really shitty collar today at the seminar. I forgot who it was. I think I let her use one of mine.
Yeah, I remember you being like, what is this?
I have no idea what it is. Yeah, all collars are not the same. Next.
Dre, so many people outside about with issues. I'm just like, I'm going to stay in my lane. When could I help fix that issue? Up to 4-hour place with my 17-week Doberman.
Wow, holy shit. Good for you. Good for you, Dre.
Nicole, hey guys, taking it day by day with my Mal. So thankful I can just go to your channel if I have trouble with training. Before you guys, she was crazed Tasmanian devil. Mm. Now she's a sweet little devil that listens.
Wow. Good for you. Yeah. Malinois can be challenging.
Jacqueline, can you recommend an indoor camera?
An indoor camera? Just get, I mean, you can get like a Nest cam. You can get a nanny cam. Like Nest is fine, right? You can do Nest.
Mm-hmm.
Nest cam or there's so many. If you go to Best Buy or something, they got tons of them. Look there. See what they got there, and then you can always order off of Amazon. I was in Nest the other day because I was looking. What did I buy at Nest the other day? I was at Best Buy the other day. I had to buy a, what did I go there for?
I don't know.
Oh, I bought there for a lock for down in Florida. I was down in Florida, and I had to buy a Nest lock for one of my new properties. No, not for the new property. Oh, for another one of the properties that I the existing property. Right. That's what it is. For the existing property that had a different type of lock on it. And I was like, holy shit. There's like, they got a ton of companies now that are making these indoor cameras that you can see from your phone. Next.
Scattered Storm is eating food off the floor, something you can correct permanently.
There's something called poison proofing. We don't really do it. But something called poison proofing, which is you're training dogs never to pick up anything off the ground. And they use it because they use it a lot. Police dogs, they should be using it with. We don't want police dogs. I'm not a police dog trainer, but we don't want them to be picking up stuff off the ground because if they're like underneath the house, if they're out in the backyard, we don't want them. You never know what they're going to eat. They might also ingest drugs too. And then also over in countries where people poison dogs and then they break in the house, they poison proof the dogs. So there's a lot of like in South Africa, a lot of people have dogs to protect their property. So it's very common for the bad guys, the bad girls to poison meat, throw it over the fence. The dogs eat it. The dogs die or pass out. And then they break in the property. So I know one of the protocols is poison proofing for them. That's not something we teach, though. Next.
JJ, I told my coworker about your videos. His dog was doing unwanted behavior. Got prong collar, ordered e-collar. Great results. First session with prong.
Holy shit. Congratulations. Thanks.
Raquel from Brazil. Hey, guys. I'm loving the show more and more every day. You guys are amazing. Lots of love always.
Hey, Raquel. Love you, honey. Bye-bye.
MW, you guys look tired. Thank you for doing this. We love you madly.
Yeah, we've been up since 4. We've been up since 4 o'clock, and we did a seminar. Days are rough. It's a 9-day. We're at the seminar for about 11 hours. We're at the seminar. It's an hour before, an hour after. We went out to dinner. Then we came here to the RV. So we're going. It's 10 o'clock now. Yeah, we're going since 4 o'clock this morning, which is no big deal. I get up at 4 o'clock in the morning all the time, but seminar days are challenging. They're exhausting. It's a lot of exhaustion.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So I'm on my feet all day long. I'm working with 20 dogs, answering tons of questions. I love it. I love every minute of it, but it's tiring. It's really, really tiring. And then we're up now. We got to do it again tomorrow, 4 a.m., bright and early, hit the gym.
Mm-hmm.
Next.
Hey, it's Christy. Jeff just got home from being out during a storm. My Dobie was penned in the kitchen, ate through the baby gate, ate the carpet on the steps.
Oh,
his crate anxiety, going to start bonking.
Was he in the crate, though, or out of the crate?
He's just penned in the kitchen, but he has crate anxiety.
Oh, you got to fix the crate stuff. Fix the crate stuff. Yeah. Dogs don't freaking go right through walls. A dog can go through a wall quite easily. Next.
Double DD. Jeff, are there any temperaments in dogs where you would advise against an e-collar?
No, not at all. Absolutely not. Nope. Nope. Because I say it so strongly like that immediately because a lot of people say yes. And I'm like, says who? Who says? Like, who makes the e-collar rule that a certain dog can't have an e-collar on? Who makes that rule? And why? And who the fuck are you? Right? So you're trying to say that what kind of temperament? Fearful dog, nervous dog, anxious dog, pushy dog, snotty dog, insecure dog. Those are all great for e-collars. They're all great for e-collars. Next.
Elsie, thank you guys. Got a dog trot. I say no, then nick him right away. He stops immediately.
Cool. Awesome.
Anirbis, Jeff, you're looking a little much tired. I wish I had your gift of gab and comebacks.
It's so funny. So do me a favor. Don't call Joelle tired, because she'll turn it into meaning she looks like shit. She takes it personally. Right? Yeah, you do.
Caitlin.
So I'll be tired for both of us.
Took my dog off the e-collar too early. I trusted him too much, but he went right back to howling unnecessarily and jumping on the back door.
Caitlin, what the fuck?
Back on it now.
Okay. Caitlin, it's working. Why are you changing it? Why are you changing it? It's working. Stop. Why do you have to get off the e-collar? Next.
Alyssa, hi, Jeff. I was curious if you would recommend working a 15-pound dog on a micro e-collar for off-leash when they are highly nervous.
Yes.
As in, shakes and shuts down if you even raise your voice. Or would you recommend confidence building before even attempting to use an e-collar?
No.
Not my dog. It's a family member who gets in trouble and is basically on house arrest because of it.
Okay, well, there you go. So, no free passes, right? What's house? I don't know what house arrest means, so... but yes, I would use it for a 15-pound, insecure, fearful, nervous dog. It's probably the best tool there is. And sure, you can still do confidence building, but you can have work in parallel. So next.
And Double DD says, thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Hey, it's Christy. Definitely going to start trying to fix the crate anxiety. I love my Blazy boy, but this is getting old.
Yeah. Love's got nothing to do with anything. Guys.
Oh, here we go.
What are you talking about?
Here we go. You going on a rant?
No, I won't. Just for that, I'm not going to go on a rant.
Okay.
That's, I'm not going to go on a rant at all. But what the fuck is people doing? So this whole thing about like, blah, 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 but I love my dog. I'm like, what is that? What is that supposed to mean? I'm not going to go on a rant. Next.
Okay. I just don't know how much longer I can honestly sit on this freaking bench.
You're getting on a camera view.
I'm sorry. I'm just trying to readjust here.
Next.
Caitlin says, sorry, Jeff. I had too much sympathy on him. He stopped completely at one point, and I thought that was it. Obviously not. Thanks for your honest response.
But it's not about sympathy. It's not about that. It's like, why do you feel bad that your dog has a shock collar on? Why? It's not a sign of failure. Do what works. Do what works. It's so important that we do that. There's dogs that have shock collars on their whole life. It's not a sign of failure. Next.
I skipped one. Elsie, thanks again. You do look tired. Get some rest. Much love.
Okay, guys.
No one's called me tired yet.
I look tired.
It's the warm glow.
Okay. I know I look tired. You know why? I'm fucking exhausted. Okay.
You're tired.
I am tired. I'm exhausted.
You're cranky. You guys don't even know. So 24/7 this guy. And he shushed me.
Next. Oh, can't wait till the fucking camera's off. Next.
Okay, Tice.
You wish I shushed you.
Took your advice for using prong collar. Major difference. Best walk we've ever had.
Good. I'm glad you did that. Yeah.
Jess. We have a one-year-old Malamute that's crated, but are adopting her brother soon, who will be older. Either 2 or 4. If the older is okay with the... You guys are putting too many questions. It's bumping me. Out of the crate, should we still crate both?
Yeah. Crate them. Life's easier. Next.
Michelle says, I love Jeff rants.
I'm not going to rant tonight.
Eterna dog training. Insta story rant coming. I think you already did a rant on that. On Insta. On love. Like what defines love.
Yeah.
I made it a highlight. It's on our page.
I'm going to be doing one on the title of a blog post I'm going to be doing soon.
Don't tell it yet. Mm-mm. No one. I don't want anyone taking that. It's fucking gold. You can't put it out there. Okay. Sorry, guys. I'm going to be that person. It's too good.
Sorry, she just shushed me.
Yep.
Next. I wanted to share.
It says, hashtag no Jeff rants. I don't know what loving my dog means. I'm just trying not to go crazy as I clean up the carpet pieces. Poor thing. I can just see it. Like, this is just a sad picture.
You're on your hands and knees. You're typing with one finger as you got a fucking bunch of carpet in another hand. Next.
Red Riding Hood and the Wolf. When would it be the best time to switch him to a prong? He currently walks on a flat, but he doesn't pull.
You can switch him today. Mm-hmm. You can switch him today. It's not just for pulling. It's just for all kinds of different communication. Next.
JJ says go to bed.
But that's not going to happen even when the camera's off. I got a lot of stuff to do tonight. Next. I still got to feed the dogs. The fuck?
Gregory.
What time is it? It's 10 o'clock. My dogs haven't even eaten fucking dinner yet.
All right. We got like three more and then we can end it.
That sounds good to me.
Gregory. Hey, Jeff. 77-pound GSD on vacation. Been working with Prong on him. Went for a long walk today. Looked like George Jefferson going to meet Weezy.
Nice. The Weezy.
So proud of him. So proud of him. Today's heel was awesome.
Hey, Weezy, what's up? Go away. Knock on the door. Who do you think's there? Next.
Mally and Dante. When Jeff is too tired to go on a rant. Guys, you look amazing, but you know, get some sleep for the fun of it. Oh, I can't wait to go to bed. He can stay up and do work. I'm going to bed.
Okay. Fine with me. You don't got to walk far.
No.
You got to go 5 feet away.
MW says, you skipped me up there. I read yours, MW. We love you, too.
Next.
Ari, hey, I ordered my e-collar this morning, and I'm so fucking excited for the possibilities.
Good. Good. Proud of you.
Next. Red Riding Hood and the Wolf says, at 3 months.
What's that, 3 months?
I don't know.
Next.
Gregory, thank you for doing what you do.
Oh, thank you guys for consuming.
Okay, this is going to be a good one. We're going to end it here.
Okay, good. The last Courtney. Question.
My boyfriend and I had a great time at the seminar today, so glad we were able to make it. Can't wait for day two. You guys are amazing. Thanks for everything.
Brittany, great to have you here. Great to have your boyfriend here. All right, tell him to not eat so much fucking food. Okay, 2 pieces of pizza per person. Let him know. All right, let him know. Other than that, it was fantastic. I really enjoyed today. Tomorrow's going to be even better. Love you guys. So we're going to end the show at exactly 1 hour because someone needs to get to sleep. Right there.
I have no shame saying it. I don't take pride in not getting sleep.
And guess what? I've got so much respect for you that I'm going to end the show now.
Thank you.
And not push you because you do enough.
Thanks.
You're welcome. All right, guys. My name is Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. This is Joelle. What day of the week is today?
Saturday.
We'll be back Monday night at 8 p.m. We'll do an 8 p.m. show on Monday night. We'll still be here in Canton, Ohio. And take care, everybody. Bye. Love you.
Good night.